Good evening, everyone. Welcome to my study. My name is Father Taming. I'm the vicar of the parish of St. George Enfield in Frizzy Water. Warm welcome to my study. This is our daily the live streaming called Thoughts for the Night. Sometimes we do a very informal, live streaming. Sometimes we do a bit more structured, the live streaming, like today. We're going to offer, the night prayer together before we say goodnight to everybody. While I'm welcoming you, the morning, joined us, Sharon, the Janice, welcome. Good to see you. I wonder, actually, you can hear me. Do you have any sort of, do you hear any background noise? Just if you hear a bit of, strange background noise, just let me know, okay? Good evening, Ronnie, welcome. Ron, thank you. Carol, I know you're together, but using, your own equipment, I think, to log in. Warm welcome to you all. Oh, Andrew, good to see you, Andrew. How are you? How is your, process, preparation is going? I think I need to actually invite you to this, the live streaming for a short interview or something, if you don't mind. Just let me know. If you'd like to do that, that would be brilliant. The Maria joined us. Georgina, welcome. Welcome. Tonight, brilliant. Andrew, my friend said, good, thank you. That's really good. Thank you. Tonight, I'm going to read the Psalm 42. Of course, the Psalm 42 has 14 verses, but probably I'm going to use the first 7 verses. And for the scripture readings, probably I'm going to use one from Jeremiah. It's a very short one. It's just 2 lines. It's just literally it's one sentence. So it might be good for us to use this one for our reflections. And then as usual, we are still the season of Epiphany, as Father Vince mentioned it during the sermon today. The season of Epiphany is actually about to finish, and then on Tuesday, that's what we called the Candlemas, the presentation of the Lord to the temple. So we normally don't say Mass on Tuesday, but I think, I need to actually check my diary, but I think we'll be able to actually celebrate the Candlemas and then doing some live streaming of Mass as well. So don't surprise, it's a Candlemas. That is a wonderful day to celebrate Mass together. Good evening, Val, welcome. And then Judith, welcome, welcome. Thank you for joining us for tonight's the night prayer. Before I say the night prayer, I've got a news to share with all of you, especially if you are a member of the St. George's Church, if you are a regular worshipper. I know some people coming on Wednesdays only, or Saturdays or Thursdays, but if you are a Sunday worshipper here with us, good evening, Jane, welcome. You will remember a gentleman called Norman Cain, not Norman Benson. Norman Benson is a different person, but Norman Cain's. The Norman Cain's. He was born in Guyana. I saw him walking on the streets a couple of days ago, and then in 2 days' time, I received an email from his daughter Vanessa. I'm sure many of you will know her. And then she said, in her email, she said, her father, Norman, has been admitted into the North Mid Hospital. And then, so we have been, praying for him. But sadly, this afternoon I received another email from her telling me that he has, died this morning. So, we have lost a member of our congregation. So, if you could tonight remember the soul of Norman, our friends. He has a great sense of, the humour, always very uplifted. And yeah, he used to sit, if you go and sit your, sits, left hand side to the back in between first and the second, the pillar. That's where he used to actually sit. Good evening, David and Gemma. Welcome. So, I'm going to miss him. We are going to miss him because he is, as far as I'm concerned, he is the first member of our church whom we have lost of COVID. So, if you can keep him in your prayer and his daughter Vanessa and all the family and friends of Norman in your prayer. He's a lovely gentleman, Jane, as you said. He's a lovely gentleman, always happy. Yes, so I think we will terribly miss him. Thank you, Debbie. Yeah, he was a very good person. So, we're going to keep him in our mind as we offer our night prayer together. So I thought I might need to actually share the news with you. Now, shall we begin? The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. And our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. O most merciful God, we confess to you before the whole company of heaven and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins, and heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Before the ending of the day, Creator of the world, we pray, that you with steadfast love would keep your watch around us while we sleep. From evil dreams defend our sight, from fears and terrors of the night. Tread on the foot our deadly foe, that we no sinful thought may know. O Father, that we ask be done, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, and Holy Spirit, by whose breath our souls are raised to life from death. Now the psalm is taken from the Psalm 42. As the deer longs for the water brooks, so longs my soul for you, O God. My soul is athirst for God, even for the living God. When shall I come before the presence of God? My tears have been my bread day and night, while all day long they say to me, Where is now your God? Now, when I think on these things, I pour out my soul, how I went with a multitude and led the procession to the house of God. With a voice of praise and thanksgiving among those who kept holy day. Why are you so full of heaviness, O my soul? And why are you so disquieted within me? O put your trust in God, for I will yet give him thanks, who is the help of my countenance and my God. glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. And tonight, the short scripture reading is taken from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, beginning at the 9th verse. You, O Lord, are in the midst of us, and we are called by your name. Leave us not, O Lord our God. Here ends the lesson. I think I could see, I could hear, kind of, you know, same, very, not same, but similar the message from the psalm that we read today, and then also from this reading from the Jeremiah. And if we see Psalm 42, as the deer longs for the water brook, so longs my soul for you, O God. And then the people keep saying to me, where is now your God? But remember, Lord, that my journey, your day and night, I pondered your word, and then I offer my thanksgiving, and I offered praise and thanksgiving to you. And then please remember, Lord, my days or my time that I spent in your temple, in your church, within your presence. I was not completely outside of your the presence. I wasn't disconnected from you. You know that I was searching for you, and I was longing for your word and wisdom. And then, oh, put your trust in God, for I will yet give him thanks, who is the help of my countenance and my God. So this is a message, or the readings from the psalm. This is a message. And then from our scripture reading, from the Jeremiah says, you, O Lord, are in the midst of us. Whatever people are saying, the outside people keep asking me, where is now your God? But I know the Lord, you are already in the midst of us. And then we are actually, Lord, we are called by your name. You called us, each and every one of us, but actually we are all called by your name. In the midst of us, you are here. This script reading tells us such a God-centric image. Of course, you and I now, I'm sitting here in my study. I'm saying this so many times, and you are sitting somewhere, possibly in your wherever, somewhere in your home, or maybe, you know, you decided to be a more penitential, so you might put outside of your garden, cold, who knows? But wherever you are, in the midst of us, even in this virtual community, we know that in the midst of us, the presence of the Lord is with us. The reason why we can say that is because of we gathered here in the name of Christ, in the name of Lord. So if we combine these two messages, message from Psalm, Lord, whatever happens, I'm still offering my praise and thanksgiving. And then this message from the Jeremiah. Lord, we are your people. You called us by your name. It is I, it is the Lord who called you out of darkness, blah, 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 blah. It forms a wonderful image of God's people going through the difficult times or any hardships or difficulties, whether that's a despair, physical hardships, mental difficulties, whatever. I'm sure you can picture that. the group of Christians like us, you and me tonight, we gathered here in the name of our Lord. And then we have the strength which is coming from our Lord, and we are actually soldiering on. This is very powerful, you know, the image, really refreshing in a way, and it's strengthening me personally. Now, it's been a long day, I have to say. Sunday, well, only one day that your vicar works. Anyway. and then I've done some chores as well, because it's a Sunday. Good day. Day of chores. Yeah. More chores, I should say. But still, at the end of today, as I sit here to offer this night prayer with you, these two readings, two scripture readings, one from Jeremiah and one from Psalm 42, made me realize again, it is not my own journey, and I'm not alone. And how wonderful it is for me to be able to say, dear my brothers and sisters, I believe our Lord, He's in the midst of us. He's in the midst of us tonight. And He will stay with us. Even if some people outside will mocking us, where is your God, then? Still we know. We will never stop bringing our praise and thanksgiving to our Lord. While we are doing that, I pray and I sincerely hope our church community may nurtured, may grow in many ways, and may our community, each and every one of us, as individuals or as a collective, you know, the group, we may able to be the wonderful example of God's presence among the people. And that's why I think nearly 130, 40, 50 years ago, people built this church. Amen. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, Lord God of truth. I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Keep me as the apple of your eye, and hide me under the shadow of your wings. Alleluia. Christ, the light of the world, alleluia, has manifested his glory. Alleluia, alleluia. Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, the light of the world, alleluia, has manifested his glory. Alleluia, alleluia. Now let us offer our prayers together. Tonight we pray for the soul of our friend Norman, who died this morning. for the repose of his soul. We also pray for Norman's family and friends. Pray for all those who are in the hospital, those who are fighting against this deadly virus. And also we pray for ourselves, each and every one of us, as individuals and as a member of this Christian community here in Freezy Water and beyond. We may be able to feel your presence in the midst of us. And whatever we do in the name of our Lord, may our souls be refreshed, may our bodies be strengthened. Particularly we pray for our church, pray for our church wardens, members of the PCC, those who are doing their part to support the mission of our church. For family and friends around us, whom we dearly miss, we pray for their security and safety. And also, we pray for the refreshing joy of following Jesus Christ. May we be the faithful disciples of our Lord. King of kings and Lord of lords, making the true light to shine. Lighten our darkness now and evermore, that with our lips and in our lives we may praise you, for you are our God now and forever. Amen. And visit this place, O Lord, we pray, and drive far from it the snares of the enemy. May your holy angels dwell with us and guard us in peace. And may your blessing be always upon us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. In peace, we will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand, and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. Come with the dawning of the day, and make yourself known in the breaking of the bread. May the living waters of Christ cleanse us. May the Spirit descend upon us. And the blessing of God be with us this night and always. Amen. So, once again, dear my brothers and sisters, thank you for joining me tonight for this the night prayer. Is there anything that I need to share? Tuesday, that's Candlemas. That's the important day. Other than that, I think everything should be fine. I wonder actually whether you have received a letter from me or not. I know some of you have received. But if you haven't actually received a letter from us, and then, but how do you know that? Yeah. But just wait for a letter. I sent a letter to all of you, each and every one of you who are on our parish electoral roll. And then I put that information on our, the parish magazine, which is out now. Oh, I completely forgot. It's my fault. I completely forgot to upload our parish magazine, the January ones. I completely forgot. So what I'm going to do is I will upload on website, possibly not today, sometime tomorrow or on Tuesday. I'm going to upload both the January and the February, the magazines. I'm terribly sorry because I thought I did, but I completely missed out. So it's my fault. Mea culpa, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. It's my fault. But I will remember to upload both the January and then February one together. Other than that, I hope you enjoy the rest of the night. Tomorrow is Monday, and then we know that the Monday is the best day in the week, full of energy, and then with that energy, I'll be able to, win this battle with my son doing, remote learning, I will survive. Have a peaceful, the night, and then sleep well, and then may the Lord be always with you and me and all of us. Now, I'm going to say good night to you all, and thank you very much once again for joining us for tonight's night prayer. My name is Father Tamin. I am the vicar of this parish, St. George Enfield, in Frazee Water. God bless you. Bye for now.